apologize for coming a bit late. I was catching up with a good friend of mine whom I met, giving a little speech, or practicing to give a speech. So I also do apologize about wearing my coat. It's a bit chilly outside, so I thought I'd keep this my coat on. It's a bit chilly, but moving on. My topic for today, honestly, is a really simple topic. It's something, it's a word you might have all heard before. Peace. Now, most of you might think, what does she mean? What is it about? But really, it's something I thought of, in the awakenings of the latest, terrorist attacks, or like terrible attacks that happened in New Zealand. And I thought of a deeper meaning of what peace meant to me as an individual. And I'm sure many other people did, maybe thought of that. Also, with a bit of volunteer work I've been doing at the University of Toronto with one of the associate professors, I was trying to develop a peace model, which was not something I thought I'd be doing. But as I grew older, I realized the goal of peace, or the concept, or the word, or definition, is really a sense of tranquility. So I thought, how can tranquility be so valuable to human, or humanity? And then I started thinking deeper. What if there was a model to use in communities, for individuals, for mental health issues, for huge political issues that have been going on for centuries? So I started digging in, some extra time I had instead of doing medicine or journalism. I'm like, ooh, let's read about peace. So it turns out that the goal or the concept of peace is to kind of develop a framework of analysis and creating and maintaining a relationship. And like relationship, that word we're all struggling to find out, whether it's the relationship between yourself, whatever you believe in, your community, or even your boss at work. You're trying to figure out what's my relationship like. So when it came down to peace, I really understood more about the various theories, and I don't want to go into details because psychologically there are lots of theories about peace. So I can go on and on talking about different concepts and theories, but really I want you guys to know the outcome of this. I wanted to understand the value of peace and share with you what the value of having a peaceful mindset or a peaceful goal or a peaceful community or a peaceful country can bring. And it turns out that there are various types of peace. And that sense of tranquility or that sense of no destruction can be divided to be applied to different categories. So I took it down to a category where it applies to an individual, and where it can apply to a community. So the main goal is to really kind of bring a sense of restoration, a sense of productivity, a sense of innovation, which I think is super important for everyone else, for everyone in general. Another issue I wanted to talk about is what can one do to really produce that sense of tranquility? Like I mentioned before, on a level of an individual, finding peace in whatever you're doing or in your existence or whatever you're doing in life is really about finding out how you can apply the concept of peace for what you want to do in life. Now, what I really studied even deeper was how peace can be applied to community. And that's what I'm going to kind of dig into. So my goal now to talk about further is to talk about the different various theories, but break it down in a different way. And that's to say that in a community, peace can easily be created or developed by developing a common goal, which I'm sure all of you know. Common goals really lead to building bonds and developing a sense of common framework, which leads to easily developed communication goals. And then, with one of the theories I had read, was that with the communication goals, it opens doors of innovation. So people can, of different backgrounds, different faiths and whatever, can actually build together, developing relationships. Those relationships open up doors for innovation. Innovation opens up doors for creation, for businesses, for better living and quality of life. You see, guys, peace has a deeper meaning than what we think it's about. It's not just about a white dove and a quiet environment. It really is about building a community with a common goal and allowing open doors of innovation and creation to develop, which can lead to really amazing things. I just wanted you all to think of what Mahatma Gandhi once said, and that's the best way to find yourself is to lose yourself in the service of others. Think about it. Serving others develops a relationship, a deeper sense with yourself, with oneself. Developing a deeper relationship with oneself can easily build on that relationship which I was talking about, which is the foundation of peace or the concept of peace, and then opening up many opportunities and many a higher quality of living rather than just living life for just living it. So I hope with that, may have not made lots of sense, but with it, I hope you all go back home and research a definition of peace and how to apply peace in general or a model of peace in your own lives and within your communities to produce a better sense of innovation and a better, even more better quality of life. Thank you so much, guys.